And here we go. Sitting out of the crystal blue waters, a gentle wind blows toward the white sands of our tropical paradise, and we turn around, and a few hundred yards. And the same markings of an actual zero, 8-5-101. Used in the second wave of a surprise attack by the Japanese at Pearl Harbor on December 7, 1941. This date is known as an infamy and is plugged into the United States into World War II. The North American T-51 Mustang is America's long-range single-seat fighter and fighter bomber used during the Second World War. In Korea and in other conflicts, Mustang was conceived, designed, and built by the North American Aviation Corporation in response to a specification issued directly to North America by the British Purchasing Commission. The prototype NA-73X airframe was rolled out on 9 December 1940, only 102 days after the contract was signed, and with an engine installed, it flew on 26 October. The Mustang was originally designed to use the Allison B-1710 engine, which had a limited high altitude 7, light-steel version of Rolls-Royce Cullen 60, with a two-stage, six-speed supercharger and armed with six 50-caliber machine guns. The aircraft proved to be the most effective of the Second World War. For late 1943, B-51Bs, supplemented by B-51Ds from mid-1944 on, were used by the United States Air Force, 8th Air Force, to escort bombers on raids over Germany, while the RAFs, two CAFs, and U.S. Air Force Army, the Army Air Force, 9th Air Force, used early-powered Mustangs and Spider bombers, roles of which the Mustang ensured Allied air superiority in 1944. The B-51 was also in service with Allied forces in North Africa, the Mediterranean, and the Italian theater, and saw limited service against the Japanese in the Pacific War. During World War II, Mustang pilots played 4,950 enemy aircraft shot down. And at the start of the Korean War, the Mustang was the main fighter the United Nations used until jet fighters such as the F-86 took over the role. The Mustang has been a specialized fighter bomber, and despite the advent of jet fighters, the Mustang remained in service with some air forces until the early 1980s. After World War II and the Korean War, many Mustangs were converted for civilian use, especially in air racing, and increasingly they have been preserved as a historic warbird that we see here at Air Show. Andrew's way high and to the right. He'll be, once again, using that high yo-yo to slow that aircraft down, reduce the turning radius, and now he starts to release the back pressure as the airplane starts to accelerate and head right back forward here for the time. Andrew's flying on the 1,000-foot show line, exactly over the woods, and is delineated by a series of construction equipment located at that point to give him a reference point for his 1,000-foot separation. Takes the airplane around at a minimum radius turn, pulling 4Gs all the way around, showing how maneuverable this great fighter is. The United States Army Air Forces were suffering decimating losses as they attacked the center of Nazi Germany's industrial production. It was not until the B-51 began to arrive in greater numbers to escort the bombers all the way to Berlin and back that the tide of the strategic bombing campaign was able to turn. Although produced by the North American Aviation Corporation after the British had requested that the company produce the P-40 Curtiss Warhawk, Dutch Kindleberger said, "I really don't want to build somebody else's airplane either." Andrew's going to be repositioning the airplane itself for a slow wall. Now watch how slowly the aircraft can maneuver itself. He comes back for his next setup. The Merlin engine, or the Packard license belt engine, is flying in this aircraft. It's water cooled. That gives the T-51 the very narrow profile and allows it to attain some of the highest speeds of any propeller driven aircraft. The scoop on the bottom of the aircraft is actually the radiator. And Kettleberger's engineers included the fellow name of Heidelberg, who escaped from Nazi Germany, actually produces 7 pounds of thrust as opposed to being a drag. And you'll hear the aircraft come by, occasionally you'll hear it whistle. We used to think that that whistle was because of the radiator. We've actually found out that it's because of the wind blowing over the open gun ports of the airplane. Let's listen to it as it comes across. That, ladies and gentlemen, is the sound of freedom. Taxi and airplane down Highway 7. Lou Beach, Middlebury Bank, Midstar Aviation, One Loudon, SCJ Warbirds, Star Buick GMC Trucks, the Re-Enhancement Group Incorporated, and Sheba Group Incorporated. Each of these organizations and individuals putting forth the maximum effort, as has our sponsors and our volunteers, as Andrew brings this beautiful, highly polished aluminum airplane, man, it just glows in the sky. And brings it back around.